This video will give you the basics on how to cite sources using MLA 9th edition. Entries in the Works Cited list are created using the MLA template of core elements. Facts that are common to most sources, like the author, title, and publication date. Using MLA format is easy. First, you find out these facts about what you're citing, and then use the template to put them in the proper order. The first element is usually the author of the work being cited. If there is no author, the first element is the title. The author's name is entered last name first, followed by a comma, a space, and then their first name, followed by a period. Sometimes the author is an organization instead of an individual. In that case, put the name of the organization, followed by a period. On your Works Cited page, your entries are arranged in alphabetical order by the author's last name or the first full word of the entry, which could be the first word of the organizational author's name or the first full word of the title if there is no author listed. The second element of the citation is the title of the work, unless there is no author, and then the title becomes the first element of the citation. The title of the work is always written in title case, meaning that the first word and each major word following and all proper nouns are capitalized. The title is followed by a period. Titles of books are typed in italics. Titles of articles are not italicized, but are placed in quotation marks, with a period at the end of the title inside the quotation marks. The rest of the citation concerns the container of the item, how it was published, by whom, and when. Items can have more than one container. For the rest of the template information, if your item doesn't have the information necessary, leave it out. For instance, journal articles often have volume or version and issue numbers, but books do not, so you would leave version out of a book citation. In an article citation, it is not necessary to list the publisher of a journal, so you would list the journal name as the title of container, but leave out the publisher. Get the idea? A container is a work that contains another work. So a journal, magazine, or newspaper contains an article. An art museum contains a sculpture. YouTube contains a video. Here's a chart with some containers and their items. The title of container is italicized and followed by a comma. So, in the case of a journal article, the title of container would be the journal name, italicized and followed by a comma. Some works are self-contained, such as a print version of a novel, and the original theatrical release of a film. In that case, the title of the work is listed in the title of source element, and the title of container element is left blank, but any relevant publication details are provided in the container section of the template. Here are some examples of container titles. AORN is a nursing journal. The Amon Carter Museum is the home of a painting of wrapped oranges. The Norton Reader contains a number of short stories. Pride and Prejudice is a standalone novel and therefore has no container, and the Occupational Outlook Handbook contains a wealth of entries on different careers, so it is one container, and since we're viewing it on the website is the second container. Here are how those items look cited in MLA 9th edition. The title of container is highlighted for your convenience. Not every item will have a contributor. But when the item does have one, the contributor name goes right after the title of container and is followed by a comma. Contributors are people like translators, editors, directors of film, conductors, composers, choreographers, etc. Introduce each contributor's name by describing the role that the person or group played in the creation of the work, such as adapted by, directed by, edited by, performance by. Contributor names are not italicized and are followed by a comma. If the source carries a notation indicating that it is a version of a work released in more than one form, identify the version in your entry. If it doesn't, leave it out. Sometimes books have different versions they call editions. These can be authorized editions, numbered editions, or revised editions. Works in other media can have numbered versions, or there could be a difference in a DVD or streaming version of a film or video. You can also use the version element to specify that you have used an ebook rather than a print book. Also, MLA does not specify whether the E in ebook is capitalized or not. Check with your professor to see which they prefer and be consistent throughout your works cited. Number. Only include the number if your item is part of a numbered sequence, like an article from a journal that has a volume and issue number, or an episode of a television series, or a serial issue of a graphic novel. The number element is written in regular font and is followed by a comma. Include a common abbreviation that identifies the kind of division the number refers to, like VOL period for volume or EP period for episode. The publisher is the entity primarily responsible for producing the work or making it available to the public. The publisher's name is written in regular font and followed by a comma. In some cases, you can omit the publisher's name, as in the case of a journal article. We talked about that a minute ago. Websites whose names are the same as those of their publisher, or a database of published content, like a library database. In the case of a library database, you would put the name of the library database in the title of container element. The publication date tells your reader when the item was published or last updated. Publication dates, if they include the month and day, are written European style, with the day first, followed by the month, spelled out, and then the year, followed by a comma. If there is just the year available, put just the year and follow it with a comma. Publication dates are written in regular font. The location depends upon the type of item. For an item with pages, the location is the page range, like the page numbers of the article in the journal. For online works, the location is either the DOI, permalink, or URL. The DOI is a unique number assigned to a digital item. DOI stands for Digital Object Identifier and is similar to an ISBN or International Standard Book Number that you will find on most physical books. The permalink is a permanent link to a digital item provided by most subscription databases. The URL is the Uniform Resource Locator or web address where you located the item. Or the location could be as simple as where you saw a play or performance. The location is written in plain text and followed by a period. Yes, even if it is a DOI, permalink, or URL. Okay, now that we understand the building blocks of an MLA citation, let's start with an easy one. A book, and just for comparison, the same book as an ebook. You will see that both items have an author and a title, a publisher, and a publication date. The only thing different in the citations is that the ebook has a version. The citations will end with the publication date because we are citing the book in its entirety and not a particular location within the book. The book is self-contained, so there is no title of container, but there is no other contributor other than the original author, and there is no number, so we leave all of those elements out of the citation. What we do is line the elements up in the proper order. They are in the same font and size as the rest of our paper, with the proper punctuation indicated by the template. And here we have a book and ebook citation in MLA 9th edition. Now, let's try something a little bit more complicated and something which you're probably going to cite a lot more often, an article from a library database. This article originally appeared in a print version of a publication called The New Statesman. I accessed it through a library database called Gale Literature Resource Center. Both of these items are containers of this article. Here's how to do a two-container citation. First, as always, there's the author element. Then second, the title element. Then we move down to container one. This will be the publication information for The New Statesman, which is the title of container, the volume and issue number, the publication date, and page numbers of the article in the publication. There was no contributor, version, or publisher, so we leave that information out. As for the second container, we access the item in the database, the Gale Literature Resource Center. So that is the title of container. And the permalink is the location. No other information is provided about the second container, so we leave that out. When viewing the article in the database, I found the author element just below the title. You might have to look around for it, but it's usually near the title. The title of the article is usually pretty prominently displayed near the top of the page. It is very important to remember to read all of the screen when you're looking at online sources. Sometimes stuff you wouldn't usually notice will have information that will be important to your citation. The first title of container is the journal name. I found this also near the title and the author's name. Again, you might need to look around for it. The volume and issue number were right next to the journal name. That's convenient. The publication date was also near the other publication information. In this case, right below the author's name. It's important as a researcher to be aware of the publication date. You don't want to be citing outdated information. Now, for the container 1 location. I had to go back to my results list. For some reason, I couldn't find the page numbers of the article on the screen where I was viewing the article. But where the article was listed in the results list, I found that it was on page 84 of the New Statesman and was 4 pages long. So I did some simple math and put pp.84-88 in my citation. Finally, we are on to container 2. The database name is probably at the top of every page you see while you're in the database. Now, let's talk about database URLs. Library databases are subscription products, and you don't have access to them except through the library subscription. Your reader may not have access to the same databases you have access to. Using the URL in your browser's location bar will not take your reader to the article you're viewing in the database, even if they have a subscription. Subscription database products are hidden under so many layers of proxy servers and security that most databases provide permalinks for the convenience of their subscribers. Use the permalink whenever possible in your reference list citation. Depending upon the database, you may have to look around to find the permalink, but it should be there somewhere. Also, the permalink is much shorter than the URLs in the browser location bar. In this case, I had to click on Link to see the permalink for the article. Some articles will have a DOI instead of a permalink, and that is okay too. According to the MLA 9th edition, including URLs in your citation do have some disadvantages. They cannot be clicked on in print, they often clutter the work cited list, and do not always offer access to the work being cited. Therefore, in deciding when to include a URL, follow the preferences of your instructor, institution, or publisher. In other words, you don't have to include the URL, but check with your instructor first. Now here is a brief mock-up of what your Works Cited page should look like. The title Works, and yes, that is Works with an S, plural because you're listing more than one item on that page, Cited, is centered at the top of the page, which you have set up with 1-inch margins in the same font and size as the rest of your paper. Use the paragraph dialog box to set up your line spacing and hanging indent. List your citations in alphabetical order, by the author's last name, or first full word of the title if there is no author. There is a copy of the MLA 9th edition handbook at the reference desk of most major libraries, and multiple copies at the reference desks of the San Jacinto College libraries. If, after viewing this video and the attached handouts, you are still having issues with citation, please come and see a reference librarian. We have the book and can help you figure out how to cite just about anything. A reference librarian is always just an email, phone call, text, or chat away, and you can come in and talk to us in person too.